Hey, it's Dr. Liu here with Better Life Research Tips. Today, I want to talk about how to write to make a paper clear and concise. Be clear and concise are top priorities for academic writing. In academic writing, our readers are usually professionals who are looking for information for their work. They're not reading for fun or to kill time. Instead, they want to save time and get their job done quickly. Think about ourselves. When we conduct literature review, we often need to read many papers, and we really hope we can grasp the main ideas in these papers within minimum amount of time. Reading a wordy and confusing paper is a headache. So when it is our turn to write a paper, we should learn to be kind to our reader. By putting clarity and conciseness as top priorities, we not only give our reader a favor, but also make our paper more valuable. Our ideas in the paper will have more chance to get recognized and be cited. Writing clearly and concisely is not easy, especially for students who have formed a habit to write unnecessary long text, because of their long-term consciousness of having to meet length requirements for their writing assignments, or simply because they want to look more sophisticated than they actually are. In the real-world academic writing, we should get rid of this habit. We should learn to be economical with the words we use. Imagine you need to pay $10 for each word you use. Would you still write your paper in the same way? We do not want to write a lot, but say little. In addition to be concise, we also want to maximize clarity of our writing. The goal is to allow our reader to skim the paper and grasp the idea within minimum amount of time. We want to cut all the redundant words and avoid all the ambiguous words. There are two golden rules here. First, if there is a possibility our writing can be misinterpreted, we should revise it. Second, if a word or phrase can be removed or shortened without losing meaning, we should do it. Generally, short sentences and short paragraph should be preferred. Typically, it is a good practice to keep most of our sentences to be less than 30 words and most of our paragraphs to be less than 300 words. A sentence longer than four lines or a paragraph occupying a full page is not reader friendly and should be avoided when possible. Be concise and clear. It's not only about using less words, but also it's about using a clear structure to allow our reader to catch our ideas in less time. After we have cut all the redundant words, replaced all the ambiguous words, and corrected all the grammar mistakes, there's still something we can do to improve the clarity and conciseness of our writing. Here are the five tips. First, for each paragraph in our paper, always start with the topic sentence. Each paragraph should just have one main idea, and it should be clearly stated at the first sentence of the paragraph. You may think this is too formulaic, because many experienced writers can actually put their topic sentences in somewhere else and still make it very impressive. But if we really put clarity and conciseness instead of style as our top priorities, we should do this. When we skim other people's paper, we want to identify their topic sentence as quick as possible. Putting our topic sentence at the beginning of our paragraphs not only save time for our readers, but also help ourselves in the writing process by making our ideas clearer. By doing this, if we put all the first sentences of our paragraph together. It will read like an abstract. Second, when comparing and listing items, always use parallel structure. Parallel structures keep the compared items in the same grammatic form. It adds balance, rhythm, and consistency to sentences, so the reader can easily follow and relate the compared items to each other. For example, we may say we want our students to initiate their own learning, to be creative problem solvers, and think independently. But this is not parallel. To make it parallel, the sentence could be revised as, we want our students to be self-motivated learners, creative problem solvers, and independent thinkers. Third, we should use active voice instead of passive voice, unless we have a good reason not to do so. Generally, active voice is less wordy, more clear, and it provides more complete information. Some writers prefer passive voice simply because they want to remove human factors in writing, or when the actor seems not important. But for others, these reasons may not be good enough to choose passive voice over active voice. To me, passive voice should be used only when it improves the clarity of our writing. For example, it can be used to keep the subject and the focus consistent throughout the passage, or to keep a parallel structure, as stated in the second tip. The fourth tip is to minimize the use of adverbs. Adverbs are words that modify verbs and adjectives. They are usually used when the writer is afraid they are not expressing clearly by using the verb or the adjective alone. In academic writing, adverbs such as very, really, basically, absolutely, extremely should be avoided. We should try our best to replace these adverbs with evidence or data, or we can remove them by using a more accurate verb or adjective. For example, instead of very clear, we may say obvious. Instead of really large, we may say huge. Instead of absolutely sure, we may say certain. Also, we prefer to use affirmative words instead of not something. For example, instead of not positive, we may say negative. Instead of not often, we may say really. The fifth tip is to avoid turning verbs into nouns. Verbs are generally less wordy, more clear and powerful, and they can move the writing along more quickly. For example, instead of conduct an investigation, we'd rather say investigate. Instead of provide a review, we'd rather say review. Instead of there is a common assumption that, we'd rather say many people assume. Also, to maximize clarity, the subject and the verb should be put next to each other whenever it is possible. And that concludes our 5 tips to make your paper clear and concise. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Liu with Research Tips for the Underdogs. Happy New Year 2019. Until next time, enjoying a fresh start for a better life.